Romare Bearden grew up in a house where Harlem Renaissance luminaries such as jazz musician Duke Ellington and poet Langston Hughes were regular visitors. He had a lifelong interest in jazz and literature, both of which played a major role in his work. As a teenager, he studied with the sculptor Augusta Savage.
I think if the artist was the only person in the world, he wouldn't paint, because you paint in relation to other people. Suppose, for instance, a friend visited me and I wasn't here, and he left a card so that I would know he was here. And the things that I do are like leaving my visiting cards, so that my works say, Romy was here. Not long ago, a young artist picked up some of my visiting cards off the cover of Fortune magazine. He was going to the little gallery, the Sinque Gallery, named for the famous African prince who led a mutiny in the 1830s aboard a slave ship. I'm on the board of directors along with Norman Lewis and Ernest Critchlow. We three established this gallery to give needed exposure to minority artists, and I think that we have some little obligation to the young, deserving people who are coming along.
I really appreciate your coming over to see my work, Mr. Bearden.
Everything looks just fine. I think it's one of our real fine shows that we had here. Are the same movements that I see in the painting, I see continued in some of your sculpture, like that piece over there. It's very similar to your painting. And it seems like you're very fond of this kind of undulating movement.
So this gallery gives these artists a kind of a pat on the back.
Gives me a lot of freedom.
Of course, it was a little different when I started to paint, which was during the height of the Depression. I had been trained at first as a mathematician, but when I got out of college, there was nothing to count but the unemployed. So I took a studio on 125th Street above that of Jacob Lawrence. The great poet and novelist Claude McKay was in the same building. And if we weren't at my studio, we usually went to the studio of Charles Alston. I met the artists and the intellectuals, and we had a real little going community. So this was a great deal in enhancing whatever development I've made as an artist. As for my own work, what I've tried to do is to take the elements of Afro-American life in this country as I see it. That is to place it in a universal framework. For instance, in my show at the Museum of Modern Art, I have a baptism scene, and I've tried to relate the people in my painting of the baptism to a myth. Even back in Africa, I've used certain masks to try to show the heritage that relates these people in my painting back to a certain past. However, I constantly, with the encouragement of my wife, who's helped me so much, try to reach within my own consciousness and memory and bring forth a people that I've known and seen, and let them take their place on certain works that I'm doing. Some stand and some sit, some sleep, just what they want to do after the painting gets started. I use papers often that I paint myself, others I buy colored. I use some photograph often from magazines, pieces of cloth and other material. In many ways, it's like putting a symphony together, or a piece of music, a certain melody going of colors, and then certain contrapuntal elements that play against this. One of my works I call The Block, and it's about a particular block, 133rd Street and Lenox Avenue, that I've tried to, in my imagination, x-ray and tell something about the life of the people. This block is another calling card that I've left. It said, I've observed and passed by that I was here.
Here is some advice he once gave to a younger artist. Become a blues singer, only you sing on the canvas. You improvise. You find the rhythm and catch it good, and structure as you go along. Then the song is in you.
Okay, so what does Romare Bearden mean by pretend you're a singer and that your song is your paper or your canvas? Well, when in a song there's a rhythm, right? There's a beat. And so he says catch a rhythm. How can you make a rhythm in your collage? So you can open up your envelope and see what's in there. So I could make a rhythm by repeating a shape on my canvas, making a pattern. That's one way to do it. And then he says improvise. What does improvise mean? Improvise means when you don't start with a plan. You just go in and maybe you look at your different interesting materials and you kind of just look at, maybe I'm going to look at this and it really like makes me think about a tree. So then I'm going to start making a tree with that. And then that's going to give me another idea. So I'm just kind of making it up as I go and letting one thing lead to the next. So let's listen to some music and we'll look at some more of those beautiful collages from Romare Bearden, and just kind of start looking at your materials, start cutting and gluing, and see where it takes you, and maybe you'll surprise yourself.
Thank you.